Hello, ladies and gentlemen. An Idiot Imports is sponsored by PlayAsia, who most likely supplied this game to me unless I specifically mentioned that they didn't. You can follow the affiliate link in the description to buy this game from PlayAsia to support me and my channel, and you can use the coupon code BLUEVITA to save $3 off your order. Thanks for your support, enjoy the show. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Blue Maxima, and I'm here checking out Jikyouu Powerful Pro Yakyuu 2016. That's a hell of a title. But for the purpose of keeping it simple for me, I'm just going to be calling it Power Pro from now on. Although, as you may have guessed by this title screen, it is a baseball game. Turns out, Japan absolutely loves baseball. It's like a national pastime for them, which is all the weirder considering that it's... I mean, I've always assumed it's like an American sport. And I mean, I have kind of known about how much they like baseball over there for a while, but seeing a game like this is... Well, it's something else entirely, I gotta say. It's just really odd. But we'll stop talking about that now, we'll actually get into the game. Also, funnily enough, did you think Konami wasn't making any games anymore? Turns out they are! This is by Konami. They also make another series like this, but it's like completely realistic. It's Pro Yakyuu Spirits. Yakyuu is the Japanese for baseball. So yeah, let's actually get into, well, this game in general, really. And this main menu is going to take us a really fucking long time to get through, and I apologize for that. When I first hit the start button on this game and I was shown this menu, I was like, oh, fuck. But yes, I have spent way too long on this game. Like, I have been playing this game for at least 15 hours. Yes, at least 15 hours. And I haven't even scratched the surface yet. Like, I'm not even close. But I have a rough idea of how all the modes work. I have a rough idea of where everything is. So we're just gonna go, as usual, have a look around. We'll start down here over in the two right columns, because these are mostly like options and stuff like that. So we'll start with the settings, as you usually do. There's a bunch of things you can do here. Unfortunately, this game doesn't support like, what's the word? It doesn't support cross-save with the console versions, which is a little weird. It does support importing save data from the previous games though, which is what that menu option is. This one, I can't remember what this one does actually. Oh yeah, it's the credits. So you can actually see a little bit of, like, this game's, like, style and flair, and it just... It's so weird. It's like chibi, but... It's like Miis? Like, there are tons of customizable characters in this. I'll be able to show you that in a minute, but yeah. You can see this, and the intro video is even crazier. Like, it makes absolutely no sense, and I love it. This game's just got this sense of style about it that I absolutely adore. And I don't know what it is. And look at this little guy. He's just doing this little dance and just doesn't give a shit. He's like the announcer. He's in all the matches and stuff because he does all the announcements and stuff too. And it's neat just to watch, really. Just looking at everything that happens in this game is just something else entirely. But yeah, that's the credits. This option here, I can't remember what this is. I know what the three on the right are. Yeah, this is just the notice for what's happened online recently. Yeah, I remember now. Now, the ones on the right, this is the cheer song that you can compose yourself. Yes, I have had, like, zero time to fiddle around with this, but this is literally just a flippin' song composer. I'm so impressed. I'm honestly really impressed. Like, this is where you come to, like, compose songs that you, this is where you come to compose songs that, you can play at the end of a, game. That's just neat. Like, it has an impressive amount of effort put into it for something that seems that's tucked away in a tiny little thing like this. There's also this menu, which is an absolute ton of sound sliders. Like, a ridiculous amount of sound sliders. I don't think I've ever seen more in a Vita game. And that's pretty impressive. We've also got background music. You can change what background music plays in what particular area. There's also an absolute ton of background music as DLC for this game. But as you can guess, I can't get that because this is my American account. So, whatever. This is the game settings menu. This is where you come to determine how stuff plays out in the game, in the actual matches. Like for example, this option here, how many innings there are. This option here, how many extra innings there can be. You know the drill, right? So there's an absolute ton of options to customize for the game here. I actually did go to the effort of translating all of these too, which is certainly something else. And I have it all written down in this big notepad file on my left screen here, because I have two screens and I'm recording on the right screen. So yeah, just, there's an absolute ton of options here. And you know what the worst thing is? Player options. Look at all them options. Look at that. Look at all of them. That's a stupid amount of options. You got player difficulty down here. You got, well, if I just go by the tabs, because I have them sorted by tabs here. But yeah, you can change the settings of the computer. You can change if the CPU controls anything in particular. Like, this is batting, running, pitching, defense, and substitution. You can change if the AI controls that. You can change the throwing controls, how you select your defense, how the ball drops. You can select things like how the cameras work, the pitching cursor, the pitching guide, and the strike zone. You can turn all of these on and off at will. This is a lock-on setting. Now, the lock-on setting is a bit weird because, frankly, I was playing without the lock-on setting, and I was doing absolutely terribly. Then I went and looked it up on a website, which I'll explain in a moment, and it said, play with at least lock-on 1 if you're new to the series. I'm surprised I wasn't on lock-on 1 already. I thought it was on lock-on 1. And it makes the game so much easier for newcomers. Like, well, not so much horrendously easy, but it lets you focus more on the timing, which is great. There's also on the second tab here, your cursor movement, the tone of the players. You can literally make them happy or sad if you want to. And you can change the hitting level and the ball speed, so you can change how fast it all goes. So you can slow the game down if you need to. If you're looking for a challenge, you can make it go really fast. And the first tab just shows you all the options in one go. There's also difficulty options on the left here. If you select easy, it'll change all the options so that the game basically turns into a just timing simulator. But then you can also put it on hard, which fuck that. Notably, your settings won't change unless you save them in this menu. Even if you change them in like any of the individual modes, it won't save. And I'm not entirely sure why that's a thing. So if we come over here, we can see our different teams. Konami has, this isn't the right screen. I was thinking of a different screen, but yeah. You can have up to 55 individual teams. And if I remember this option correctly, you can actually download them from the internet. Was it this option? Yes, it was this option. So you can select from a weekly stat or a all over stat, and you can select a team and you can download it and you can use it in any of the individual modes. So let's just say I download this one, for example. It'll give me the stats about the team. I select a slot and it lets me save the team to this slot. So if I back out, see, there they are. Now I just need to remember how to access that team. Yep, this is the right team. So yeah, you can see just who's in the team and how it works and all that. You can rearrange the order that everyone in this team is in. You can have all your spare players down here and on the right here for substitutions. You can change all the players around on the field. I actually didn't, I knew fuck all about baseball before I started playing this game, so I had to learn fast. But yeah, you can see the all the different players here. You can press triangle and you can get a view of all their stats. I'll go into how that works shortly. Yeah, you can see, you can make 55 custom teams. You can make thousands of custom players. At least I think you can. I mean, the list doesn't have an upper limit as far as I can tell. because this is where you come to have a look at your players. You can make thousands of custom players, you can put them all on teams, and then you can send them all into the main modes. And there's more that you can do with the system as well, and I do plan on showing you this shortly. That's the word for it though, shortly. But while we're in this menu, if I hit this option here, you can come and have a look at all the teams that were included as part of the licensing. These are all actual baseball teams in Japan. So the Yakult Swallows, the Dina Bay Stars, the Rakuten Eagles, the Buffaloes. These are all actual teams with actual players that they've licensed. They don't have any like actual likenesses, but these are like the actual players. And they've all got massive amounts of stats too. I'll go over how all these work, but basically, all your stats down on the left here in the first and third tab here, these are all your batting stats and your defense stats on the left there. And these are also your batting skills on the right. You can see 7 individual skills up the top there that everybody has, and then 24 unique skills that everyone has down there in the bottom. These are impossible to translate by yourself if you don't know what you're doing, if you don't have at least a decent knowledge of the Japanese language. However, the website powerprotranslation.com has a full translation of all these skills. So if you're absolutely determined to get down and dirty with this game system, you are more than welcome to go there and have a look for yourself. There are blue skills, which are good skills, red skills, which are bad skills, and green skills, which are computer skills. It actually determines how the computer wants to use the player. That's pretty neat. Like, being able to tell the computer, this character is good at doing X and Y, but they're not very good at doing C. At Z, sorry. So you want them to do X, Y, but you don't want them to do Z. You can actually set that as a thing, which is pretty cool. You can also set a lot of stats about them. Like, this baseballer here was born, like, 4 months before I was. Fuck me, I feel old. But yeah, you can have a look at all the different players here. They've all got, like, names down there. So even if you're having trouble telling them apart on this list on the left there, you can have a look through. You can take notes about who's good at what. You can see all this here. And it's all really neat. It's all just really well outlined. And we can even come here and have a look at all my custom players. You can download custom players off the net, and I will show being able to do that shortly. You can also do a bunch of other things, like for example, you can hire actual players, and I will show off how you can hire, and by hire I mean scout, players off the internet. But there are a bunch of other things I can show you as well. I just need to remember what all these bloody are. That is erased data. I don't want to do that. I do not want to do that. You can come here to select a voice pack for the individual players. And this is a search screen. So if I put in one character here, you can see all the different voice packs. And they show up from time to time. If I hit back out, it'll save there. I'm just trying to scroll to where my listings are in this area. Here we go. So yeah, that's audio. Here you can come here to view their individual stats, or you can even edit them in case you want to. So yeah, you can actually edit them, which is kind of neat. So you can make like a full-on recreation of a regular baseball player if you felt like it. Equipment, which basically just lets you change how they look visually. So yeah, you can see the different bats, the different color of the mitt, the different armbands. You can reset it back to default, which I just did because that means it won't save and I won't have to wait so I can get back into the face customization. This is actually quite complex. So what I'm going to do is this button here. Not this button here, sorry, that's the password input. It's this button. This button lets you change what they look like at the drop of a hat. It's really diverse. You can make an absolute ton of different characters with this. It's great. It looks awesome. It goes to show just how far they're willing to stretch this style. It's really impressive. You can also change the number on their back, which is pretty neat. There's form, which is animations. So there's a bunch of different animations you can pick. So watch this. Now, if I scroll down to this one, doesn't look that much different. But yeah, you can change. There's an absolute ton of different animations. What about this one? Yeah. Not that much difference, actually, but there's tons of individual animations that you can do, which is nice. And you can also change the name that's on the back of their jersey here. So yes, you can have them all, you can have the back of all of them say fuck puppies or something ridiculous like that. And you can also change their actual names. So yeah, you can come here to change their nickname, their first name, their last name, and how their name is displayed. Notably, if you leave this all empty, it'll actually assign them a random name. So, you know, if you don't feel like creating names for all your individual players, you don't have to. Let the game do it for you. This up here is the training mode, and the training mode is actually very highly recommended because, as I said before, I sucked coming into this game at first because despite the fact that the game is quite arcadey, it's actually very difficult to get a hang of. You've got five individual kinds of training here and they're all useful, every single one of them. There's hitting practice, there's pitching practice, there's fielder practice, there's offense practice and defense practice. Offense practice is a combination of hitting the balls and running the bases. Defense practice is a combination of pitching the balls and trying to catch them out and throwing them to the bases. And these are all very useful kinds of practice, and they've got tons of individual things with them, because you can set the AI to do like individual pitches, or you can send them, or you can set it to say, hey, do every pitch in a random order so I don't know what's coming, and stuff like that, right? And it'll tell you whether or not you've done a good hit, and hopefully ways to get better, because it can do that. It's extremely good like that. If you come here to the live area here, this is where you come to recruit, like, boots on the ground. And you can come here to this menu, and you can pick out a member based on their stats, and if you like them or not. If I was to hit circle, it would let me see all the different stats this guy has here before letting me pick him up. And, excuse me, and you can... Yeah, you can pick any character you want, basically, from this, if you have the PP, or the power points. And the power points are given to you for playing pretty much every mode in the game, so if you want to get a really strong player, you can save up for them. You can also come here to have a look at, like, the top-rated players of all time. So yeah, look at this guy. Look at this guy! This guy's got S in everything. He's got almost all the good skills that I can imagine. He looks like the absolute best pitcher. This guy's got more than 24 skills, bloody hell. This guy's like the absolute best pitcher and hitter that I could possibly imagine. And you can see by the colors there on the player name plate. So if I just back out of this, so you can see the player name plates on the very left there. That actually tells you what they do. Actually, I have a reference for the colors here so I don't get this wrong. Just let me scroll back up to them. This like reference of shit I've got here is absolutely huge. There we go, five colors. Red is your starter and pink is your relief. For your pitches. The yellow is your infielder, the green is your outfielder, and the blue is the catcher. Notably, you can also have people that are skilled in more than one role at once, as you can see. So that's really neat, because you can have one player be good at more than one thing, and it's cool. So yeah, you can do that. You can also come here to put in the password to download people, but I don't know any. You can also come here to check out all the people that you've downloaded in the past. There is a neat little feature though that might go unused if you don't know about it. Pay 100 power points, which is an absolutely tiny amount, and you'll be given a random player. And unfortunately, I seem to have gotten a piece of shit. Wonderful. It is actually possible to get a good character from this. Because I got one that was actually really decent. But let me see if I can actually get a good one. Hey! Hey, that's not actually bad. He's got some decent stats on him. I mean, for a starter player, that's not bad. So yeah, 100 points for that, well worth it. So yeah, you can just sit there and like just spend hundreds upon hundreds of points getting tons of random troops. And like, for some reason, whenever I translate this game, it calls it like the battleground and war and stuff like that. So whenever I think of this game, I think of it as like a war simulator, which is weird, but you can get hundreds of troops and then import them into all the other modes, which is cool as hell. Like, seriously, that's ridiculously awesome. There are more things to go over. I haven't had much experience with this yet, but it lets you make a pitch. No, I'm not kidding. You can modify how pitches in this game work. And Oh man, I'm amazed. Like, you can do an absolute ton with this. You can make an absolutely ridiculous pitch. You could do all sorts of crap. It's just, it's something else entirely. It's so weird. You can also use things like items here to learn different pitches and stuff like that. And I will go into what items are very shortly because I'm about to go into the shop. After I show you that this game's got online multiplayer. Yes, yes it does. And you can take your custom teams and your custom players with you. So that is indeed a thing that can occur. It's also got ad hoc. So if you have two friends that have this game, then there you go. This usually doesn't take this long. There we go. Yeah, ad hoc and online multiplayer. But yeah, I don't even know why I bothered going to the menu, honestly. But yeah, there you go. That's just those. Oh man, we still got so much more to do. I don't even know how I'm going to do this, honestly, because this is certainly something else. You can come here to check out DLC and receive items. But there's also the ability to come and purchase items here. Absolute ton of them. These do all sorts of different things. Like, they change your guy's mood. They change what abilities he can do. You can do specific things after you buy some of these items. There's a ridiculous amount of things here. You can buy cards for the Saku Success Mode, which I do plan on showing you. And there's items for the Festival Mode that you can buy that you can take with you. There's, oh my god. This is items for Pennant, I think. They'll do all sorts of different things for your troops. These look like, yeah, these are the players. I think this is the players that you can get. You can just buy players. Yeah, you can buy an absolute ton of stuff. Now to show you how it all works. How do I plan on doing this? First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show off Saku's success mode, because it's absolutely ridiculous. Also, I've known, you might be wondering what the hell this live stuff is. Well, this live stuff actually rewards you every time, well, not every time you get on, but it rewards you like every week or something with fresh items that you can use in game, which is kind of neat. I'm going to show off Saku Success Mode first though, because Saku Success Mode is one of multiple ways you can construct new people. So I can select okay, he gets a random voice pack, then we can just set what his abilities are. So this is right hand and left hand, and then how he decides to bat, so I'll make it so right of both. This is his role as a person, so pitcher, catcher, baseman, shortstop, and outfielder. I'll make him first baseman. I like being the first baseman. You can select his form here, and you can select what his favorite baseball team is, because selecting what their favorite baseball team is actually determines where they go in the My Life mode. You can also take along different cards, and these different cards are context sensitive. So if you land on a space that lets you use those cards, they'll get used. If you have a card that'll turn you into something at the beginning of a round, it'll do that. So we started here. This is a board game where you basically, the idea is you have to make yourself as powerful as possible while gaining a goal while still having stamina. If you don't get to the end while, if you run out of stamina and you're not at the end, well, you lose this player. So it is a bit of a risk reward situation. You do also have the cards, which you can translate, like you are capable of translating them, and you have a bunch of things you can do on this board. So you can have a random effect when you step on these purple squares, and they'll give you bonuses. The blue squares give you stat boosts, and I want to go and get that, I want to go and get that treasure chest, so I can actually choose not to go into the goal at this time. So I'll come down here, get as many of these stats as I possibly can, and I get an item chest that has a big stat boost, but I think it was for a boost of, I'm not entirely sure, but yeah. You can get a mood increase, you can get things that'll like shuffle the entire board so that you don't have to deal with them, and we can choose whether or not we want to go on to the next stage, and we can also come here to check out the guy's stats at the moment. So, he's actually looking alright for a beginner, baseballer, for a beginner, hitter, I should say, but for the purpose of demonstration, we'll continue on, because there's something that eventually happens in this mode that's really weird. You do also get to run into people, and they give you things like random skills. I'm pretty sure I just got a skill. Yeah, I did. So he just gave me a decent skill, which is nice. So this is just like a really quick way to make a new character. This mode goes for about 5 minutes. This is a panel shuffle, so I can actually, so now I have to pick a different way back, but thankfully it looks like not only is my way back clear, well, for the most part, I guess. Unfortunately, I lost some stats there. Not only is my way back mostly clear, but I actually get some stats here as well. So let's head to the goal. We get some stamina back, and we get to move on to the next stage. There's 5 stages in all, so it doesn't go too far. And, oh dear. Oh, all right, I'll have to come this way then. So this guy gives me a bunch of bonus points. Awesome. We'll work our way up here, get a random event, get what's in this chest. New skills? Yay! Awesome! Grab as many stat boosts as I can. Unfortunately, that was a random effect. But yeah, look at this guy. This guy's C rank in Isle Deer. Here comes the fat bastard. Yes, I honest to God have no idea what they were thinking when they came up with this. Ow. Unfortunately, I'm out of stamina. So, yep, unfortunately, that just ended the game completely for me. So, I don't actually get to keep him, unfortunately. It does give me the option to restart, but I don't think we'll bother. So, yeah, you do actually have to get to the end of a stage to have, to actually keep them. So, yes, that's about as ridiculous as this game gets, but it does have a bit of silliness still left in it. So, I'm going to try and show off as much as I can of these 4 main modes here. However, the majority of them I don't have that much time in, because a fair amount of them are focused on spending a lot of time in them. Then we'll come over and show off this mode. But this mode here is basically just a free match mode sort of thing. You can come here to play a game. You can play a game as a Harakiri, a Narakiri mode. And, or Narikiri, it's pronounced something like that. But basically, it's like My Life mode, where you can play the role of one individual player down on the field as them. So it's not just like the game putting you as a third-party entity into a baseballer or having control of the entire field at once, you know? It just has you playing the one guy, which is neat. You can play as a supervisor to have tactics against all your other people, and you can just watch. That's entirely possible. You can just watch. But anyway, I'll go and do My Life mode first, because this is the mode I have the most experience in. So we'll just go hop straight into this. Let it load up, because it will take a while, and we can continue. Some of these modes have multiple save slots, some don't. It's a bit strange like that. So, this is Koyano-chan. He is my current player, basically. He is a player that I got an absolute ton of time in with in the Saku success mode. Unfortunately, it didn't turn out as good as the one we had going there, but there you go. And he's actually a really good player. Like, he's doing very well for himself. His favorite team was the Dina Bayhawks, Bay Stars, I keep forgetting. And he got put into the second squad. And then he moved his way up to the first squad by doing well enough in the game. So yeah, you can have relationships with people in this mode, because these modes are actually fairly story driven. You can have an absolute ton of relationships going here. You can actually get married. And you will eventually end up retiring. You can select what your practice preference is. This is stat screens and all that. You have missions that you need to do to make you look better to the people. You can come here to check out your overall stats. Unfortunately, I'm not that good of a player skills wise. I wish I had more skills. You can actually train in the summer. It's the spring. So you can train in the spring training session in order to have better skills. So this is trophies that you get, like home run commemorations. You can have a hit commemorations. You do all sorts of stuff. You come here to these are items. I think they are anyway. Yeah, these are items. So you can use these items to do specific things. Like I don't actually know what these are because I haven't translated them. But I assume these are like invitations to stuff and different stat boosts and stuff like that. We can come here to check out the stats of the entire league, because there is a league going on in the background behind us. And you can see the entire rest of the team here. You can do all sorts of crap. So yeah, you are basically playing as one player. And if we go on the fly, because we were at an away match in the previous day, and now we go back home, we can do all sorts of things. We can train our stats. So this is a lot like Trillion God of Destruction, if you remember that game, where you could train individual stats and level them up and stuff like that. However, the difference between that game and this game has like 30 years of game time or something behind it, and I'm currently like 4 months in. So you can train to become an absolutely ridiculous player if you are willing to put the time in. There's also a bunch of other things you can do as well. Like, you can go out on the town to see specific events and spend money and stuff like that. You can call a friend. You can go out on a date. Yes, that is a thing. Somehow I got a girlfriend in a game, which kind of beats how I'm doing in the real world. I don't even know what this is. And this is your relationship status screen again. Yeah. So you can see how well I'm doing with all my individual relationships. And you can call people up for, like, advice and help and stuff like that. And you can just talk to them. Most of the dialogue in this game, though, isn't particularly, what's the word I'm looking for? It isn't particularly, there's a ton of dialogue, and a lot of it isn't relevant. If you want my advice for playing this game, like, at all, skip the wide dialogue, and only translate with, like, a screen translator, like the, Google Translate app on your Android phone. Only translate stuff that's in a different text color than white, because trust me, that text will usually be pretty important. If you go out in the town, there's actually a bunch of different places you can go, and once you visit a place, you can visit a place with like a person or a event going on, and once you visit a place, you can level it up, and its effect will become more pronounced. So, like, so if I was to come here to the restaurant, for example, you can say yes or no at specific points, and it costs money. And I've got money down the bottom right there, along with the amount of fans I have. I have 1,200 fans. I've been getting a lot of fans recently because I've been... What's the word I'm looking for? So that actually restored some of my stamina, which is great. Because that means I'm in good shape for the next game. Which I will be playing in the nighttime portion of this event. But yeah, the idea is you can actually travel to different places and they'll upgrade as you visit them more. So they'll get better and better as time goes on. And let's actually go out on the... Well, we can't go on a date. I don't think we can because it's not a free day. But you can call your lovely little waifu chin here and say hi. And this will actually increase your relationship with them. I am actually going out on a date. So yeah. Just do all sorts of little events like this throughout the story. And it's great. And you get tons of little, like, stat boosts, and it costs money to do stuff like this and stuff like that, obviously. And, yep, I've seen this screen before. You want to know what that second option is? Propose marriage. Thankfully, I do not have the money for that, so we can just ignore that for the time being. But she does like a little bit of company, and the dialogue actually does translate all right, except if you've got an English name as, like, the person's nickname. Because if that happens, then, oh god. Oh god, is it a pain in the ass to translate that properly? Because the Google Translate app tries to pick it up as Japanese and fails. So it just kind of fucks up the translation royally. Do I want to play a game at this point? No, I don't. Like, I know you probably want me to play a game at this point, but I want to go over the other modes first. So if we come here into the settings menu, there's a bunch of other things to come and do here as well. Like, you've got the usual game settings and stuff like that. But you actually have to come and save and quit. There's no auto-save. So, yeah, be fully aware that if you exit the game, you will not save your progress. But yeah, that My Life mode is probably the most interesting one of the lot that I've played, because you can literally take a character from like, let me just map this out for you. Since you have a rough idea of how everything works, well, not everything, but I'll explain how it works. You can create a character in either Saku Success mode, or you can send them through high school in this mode, which I will show off right now after I'm done with this explanation. You can create a character in either one of those two modes. You can send them through My Life mode after they've graduated from high school. You can put them in the pennant in order to just work their way up to the top of the Japanese Baseball League. And you can do this all entirely on one character. I'm not even kidding. And that's not even getting into what the success mode actually is, but we'll get into that very shortly. So let's actually go and check out the high school team management mode. And I won't be playing a game after this one either. I'm sure I've listed like the timestamp in the description when I actually start playing. But yeah. There's this mode is a little bit different in comparison to My Life mode. But the idea is, do you remember Virtua Tennis? This game is different because it actually lets you in both the pennant mode and in the high school baseball mode, you can set your time all the way from 1941, which is before the Second World War. Is it before the Second World War? No, it isn't. It's in the middle of the Second World War, sorry. But yeah, you can set the time from 1941 to 2016. So you can actually have, like, relevant baseball players going through high school, which sounds like the weirdest thing in the world, and it quite is. But yeah, this is a slightly different mode, because you're managing a high school baseball team. They come and go depending on the year, because Japanese high school life is 3 years long. So you can have a bunch of different baseballers here, and when they leave the school, hopefully you get the option to actually export them into your roster. But yeah, you can select them, you can select what training they're doing, because as you can see, there's a bunch of different things you can train them in, and you have to choose what to train them in at the start of every month. And every day they get a boost in what they're training in. Or you can just set the AI to do it. That's entirely possible. You have items to use. You have options to set. Like, you can set the roster for everything that's going on, obviously, because there are games to be played. Excuse me. There's options to be set there. There's a poll note system down here, which will, like, give you, like, tutorials and stuff, and a log of everything that happens throughout the game. And here's a bunch of, like, advice. It's weird, I started out this month with like 4 options and then there's like 50, so... yeah, you can do all sorts of crap like that. Now, if I go and hit up on the D-pad, it lets me check out what the upcoming panels are. And as I said before, this game's a lot like Virtua Tennis 4, where you have cards here, and these cards, not only do they all have their own individual effects, but if you land on a particular panel, it also has a particular effect. So blue panels are good. I want to land on blue panels, because they always have positive effects, and there's also effects that can happen here, and it increases like their stats and stuff. You eventually want to start skipping through all this, because yeah, this girl just never stops talking. And there's another hint that I probably should have translated. I've only been playing for a couple of months in game time, because seriously, this game takes ages to get through. Like, this game mode in particular just has an absolute ton of time you need to put into it. But yeah, you get a bunch of stat increases, there's a positive event that happens, and we can just continue on. If you hold L and circle, it skips through as much as you can possibly can. And there's also pressing start and stuff like that. There's also another game coming up. But again, I won't be actually going into this game, because the games in this mode take a really long time. Because what happens is you actually have to manage the team. You don't take an active part. You tell them what strategies to do in the game. And depending on how well they're trained in those particular strategies, they'll do them. And there's also apparently a tournament coming up. So yeah, there's an absolute ton of like stuff to do in this mode at the very least, because you can go through for as long as you damn well please, as far as I can tell, and you can make a decent baseball. Like the limit in my life mode is 30 years, I think. In this mode, since there's you can go all the way back to like 1970 or something like that, or 1940, you can go on for like 30 years. Is they just watching them all, like, practice in the background stuff like that, too? It just need to look at. This game's got a really nice visual style. And that model on the right there is actually a model. It's actually 3D. That kind of surprised me. It looks 2D, but it's actually 3D. But yeah, eventually you will get to a match, and depending on how well you do, if you win or you lose, it determines on which route you can go on. There's also cards and events that can do specific routes, so, you know, you have a better chance of landing on a bunch of good events in a row or stuff like that, right? So it's a very, like, hands-off sort of training mode. It's mainly meant for the tactics of, like, raising your own baseball team, but I still like it. It's still really neat that this mode is in here. And once you get through all, like, the introductory text, like, all of these modes have an absolute ton of introductory text. Once you get through all of it and maybe translate it via the screen translating programs, it works really well. Pennant mode, yeah, we'll go into pennant mode next, because why not, right? It doesn't really matter which mode I pick next, because I've made you understand that you can take a player through, like, as many different modes as you possibly can imagine. There's multiple pennant saves, thankfully. And pennant mode is, well, it's your basic team management mode, more or less. We've got a schedule here of things we can do. If I hit square, it actually lets you skip to relevant parts of the year, like the playoffs and stuff like that. I know it's not called playoffs in Japan's terminology, but, you know, that's just how it works. I am playing the Hawks right now because I couldn't be bothered making my own custom baseball team just for this. And you can see the lineup of players we've got here. You can trade for them. You can hire new ones. You can reorganize them on the roster. You can set up their training and just like in the other mode, or it's the high school management mode. Sorry, you can set up what stats they're going for. You can just do all sorts of crap with that. So yeah, this is all for managing your current crop of players. You also have to hire you also have to hire coaches, and you have to hire talent scouts. They'll get you different kinds of players, and they all have their own letter ranks and stuff like that. So if I come here, you can also come here to buy players. You can set up you can say, "Hi, I'm looking for all these different kinds of people here." Unfortunately, that doesn't really seem to be a thing right now. Generally, you can only do it during, like, the summer period, or the spring period, where you are looking for actual players. Like, they don't let you actually let you do it for some reason. This is where you come to, like, set up talent scouting. You can come here to bring in your custom players. So I actually brought in Kiwano as a player here, but he doesn't actually have the stats from his run in the... Oh, maybe he does. No, I don't think he does. I got that up to 50. He doesn't have the stats from his My Life run as of yet, but I'm sure he could. There's probably a way to do it somewhere. And there's also, I don't know what the screen is in the slightest. Yeah, as you can tell, I haven't actually done much in this mode, but you get the idea. It's your basic sort of season mode sort of thing. So there's also a shop where you can come to upgrade, like, the exercise equipment for better stuff. You have fans in this mode as well, so you have an absolute ton of fans, and you can win and lose them depending on how well you do in games. And there's also this. You have different people talking to you. There's help screens that you can skip with the start button. And you can play games in any one of different ways. There's you can choose to skip the games entirely. You can fast forward through them. You can actually play in them. There's all sorts of stuff like that. I'm currently coming fourth in the roster, but that's because there's three people tied for first. You know the drill. So yeah, that's pennant mode. Again, won't be playing a game in it because, well, really no point because my team sucks right now. But that's probably because I haven't had the time to actually sort through this entire mode yet. Because seriously, the amount of time I've spent in this game and I feel like I barely scratched the surface is ridiculous. The final mode is success mode. Now, success mode is like the story mode of this game. Like, there's my life mode, sure, which is kind of a sort of generic story mode here. But you've got three different scenarios here. They're all different, and they all have different goals behind them. This one is, you have a baseball team, they're gonna get dissolved. This one here is, build a baseball team. This one here is, make a grass baseball team as a retired professional player. So yeah, you can only do these after going through the particular scenarios, or at least I think that's how it works. It might also require you having a very specific player to do them. But these are very story-focused. They're also kind of like the My Life mode, except it's a bit of a simplified one. You've only got stamina to worry about, or stamina and money, I guess. And you have to build your own guy's stats. You can upgrade his stats via skill points, and this actually comes into play later on, so I won't go over just how this works just this yet. You can, of course, go and get and buy items and stuff like that. You can go out on the town and go to different places and try and get different events to happen. And, of course, you can practice, and you can lose energy by doing this, so you have to rest up regularly, and yeah, you get the drill. But yeah, I get all these different skills and all that. There's also a bunch of story events. Like, this game is the most story driven of them out of the lot, because if I just hit square here, square is the fast forward button, there's just an absolute ton of stuff to read, and there's not that much gameplay development that happens between them. So yeah, I mean, like, you can press the R button and have a look at the text log and translate it if you feel like it. But yeah, this is definitely the most text-heavy mode of the lot. But you do have to try and earn as much as possible in terms of, like, both personal relationships and stats in this one. So, I mean, My Life mode would be easy to play just because everything they say isn't entirely relevant to how the story works. But yeah, that's how this mode works. You've got a year in game time in order to get this stuff done. So Again, we won't be playing, but I promise you we're getting close. But you understand how all the big modes outside of the mode I'm about to show you works right now. Because this game has an absolute ton of depth and time that you can put into it just in those modes alone. And, well, Festival isn't a very big mode in and of itself. But I can happily actually play it now because this actually lets you play games and we can show you how this works. So, this option here, by the way, is just an advertisement for the free-to-play version that's on the Japanese store. So, we'll ignore that. And we'll head into Festival Mode. Festival Mode is... it's basically an arcade mode, more or less, right? Holy shit, I've been at this for 45... I only just looked at the amount of time I've been spending on this game. And I'm 45 minutes in and I haven't even played a fucking game of baseball yet. Holy shit. But yeah, this is Festival Mode. They call it Powerful Festival. But yeah, this is a cutscene. It's like there's a whole story and stuff behind this too. And there's really no point in hitting continue because, well... This game's like an arcade mode in the sense that if you lose once, your save game is done. So I might as well show you how it is from the very beginning. Again, you can make a character like this and have them be like a bunch of different things. But yeah. So yeah, you can see just how the animations are different and their play style. And you can't change their appearance from here. But once you get to the end of the game, end of the festival mode, I should say, you can export them out into a custom troop. So if you get a really good roll going on this one particular guy here, well, you can do that. Absolutely fine. So, yeah, you've got story cutscenes, and then you can choose what items you want to take along with you. Now, notably, this is the one mode in the game where the lock-on is actually disabled by default, and you need to take an item with you to actually make it work. There's also things like stat boosters that you can bring along. There's something that can increase all your people's mood to maximum. There's a bunch of stat boosting items. You can re-roll like who you have to fight in the actual game itself. There's all sorts of stuff here. So like, and this game mode is actually inherently replayable, and I'll be able to show you why. That's why I call it an arcade mode. I'll just hit start to skip the cutscenes here, but I mean, they're just text screens. You've also got different managers that you can take along that will give you different like bonuses and stuff like that. But thankfully, it lets you pick a bonus. It lets you change between them throughout the game for different things as well. But they give you a boost to everyone throughout the game, and they also give you a secondary boost for just one match. So I'll just skip all the cutscenes here. You also get to take along people that you've beat with you. Every time you beat someone in this game, you get to pick their players if you beat them by a wide enough margin. And these players' stats carry over from game to game. So this lady here, whose name I can't remember, is the best pitcher I have available at the moment. She's currently got some of the best stats available. She's really good at all her individual throws. And I just like this guy here because I have the affectionate name of Fat Bastard for him, because Fat Bastard is quite appropriate for his player model. So we'll take him along as well. As you can see, you can take a maximum of 4 people. You might be able to take more later on because I haven't proven wrong before. But yeah, that's just how that works. So these guys actually level up in-game, and then you can carry them between games. So you can come back here and keep playing over and over again to get more people, to get better. Like, I played a bunch of games where I couldn't get past round 2, then I got to round 4. So there's an absolute ton of stuff you can do. Like, I won a match, like, my third match in the match that I got to round 4 in, I won 17-16. It was a very tense match. But yeah, this is just a different cutscene. So, not much to talk about here, but it's a lot of these games are actually laid out in like a very similar sort of way. So yeah, you've got all the game modes you can change here, but some of this you can't change, obviously. So we can come back here to change things. We can also change the some of the game options here, and they will save for this game at least. But yeah, as you can see, can't turn on the lock-on. It's just something that doesn't happen. There's an absolute bunch of stuff here that you can still, that you can change. So, I should probably just stop wasting your time. We're almost at a game, I promise. Items, you actually get items as you win. I'll explain that in a moment. Now, this is where you come to apply XP. This is also a lot like Trillion God of Destruction, where you can get batter skills, you can get pitcher skills, you can get AI skills, and these all cost XP, and you can also get individual stat increases, and this is all very useful indeed. My guy isn't a pitcher, so I want to be increasing these skills here. So if I just scroll down here real quick, these are the batter skills, and these are the pitcher skills. And these all do different things, like, they all do things like, they make your pitches faster, they make you harder to determine, they make you harder to get fatigued, all sorts of stuff like that, right? It's designed more to make players that are, not so much overly powerful, as nuanced, as how different things work, judging by my reading of the Power Pro Translation website. So, it's a really interesting system. I actually really like it. It's a neat idea. But anyway, I'm just going to spend all the experience points I have on just different points. Get them above F and everything, because, again, XP doesn't apply to any of the other characters. This is all for you. So you can apply as much skill points to yourself as you want, because trust me, if you lose, you won't be around to... well, actually, you can apply skill points. You can come here to check your character, how all your other characters are doing, because all these guys level up individually too. But again, they level up quite slowly, and since they reset every time, it's not something you want to worry about that much. And you can also come here to check how your managers feel about you. Yeah. Also, you take along Glasses fella here with you every single time, and he levels up individually as well. So, yeah. There is a reason to keep coming back, because your team continues to get better every single time you go through. So, as you can see by those five question mark blocks there, this game is played in a series of five rounds. Every individual round, you can pick who you want to play against, and you can... No. Triangle is the button to, recycle everyone, to get a different set of people to play. You can come across the most powerful people in the game in round one. That's entirely possible. Kind of sucks when that happens too. So if you hold square, you can see that you see what items you win every time you win against someone, and you can also see what people you can get and what a role they play. So like this guy here, you can unlock that guy as a third baseman. You can also get a replacement. So yeah, that's a thing you can get. However, it's determined by how many points you win by. So if you win by like 3 runs, you get everything. But if you win by like 0 runs, you get nothing. So you actually have to not only determine who you can win against, but how much you can win against them by. I'm just going to play against this one because those 3 scrolls are actually pretty useful. And even if you haven't used items at the end of your run, you still get to take them back. How far are we into this recording now? 52 minutes and we're just about to get into a game. Unfortunately, you can't skip this one. You can hold square though, so I'm going to hold square. So yeah, this is just your back and forth taunting at the beginning of the game. It doesn't really tell you that much. So yeah, now we can use an item. Should I use my lock-on item so that I don't that I last more than one game? I will. I'll use my lock-on item. Just to be safe. So you can come in and change your layout of your people. I don't remember what my guy's name is, so I don't know where he is. But thankfully, the way this game mode works is that it sort of like jumps between exciting moments in the game. So I'll be able to show you what both pitching, batting, and fielding looks like, at least from the third person glory sense. I won't be able to show you Narikiri mode. I might show you Narikiri mode just because you've stuck around for so fucking long, and this video is easily going to be over an hour at this point. But yeah, I'll be able to show you at least how some of the base gameplay works. Oi! Except there's a girl there. it's Jasmine, huh? You can see the audience in the background there. They're all weirdly animated, and that just makes me like them more. I don't know why. Like, they're obviously missing frames of animation, but everybody else is doing fine, so that's kind of neat. You can actually choose, like, whether or not your audience is, like, dynamic, in the sense that things like rain and how popular a team is will actually affect the audience count, and that's pretty great. But anyway, round one of the Powerful Festival. Thankfully, I get to do some practice pitching, so I can show you how this works. So the idea is, you can choose what pitches that you can do. Every individual pitcher has their own pitches, and you can choose what pitches you want to do and how experienced you are in them. So depending on the pitch, you actually use a lot of stamina up, and obviously there's a stamina meter down the very bottom right there, and it'll give you, brain work with me here. It'll give you, it'll make you weaker, more or less resistant to, what's the word I'm looking for? More or less resistant to, like, getting dizzy or something like that. So that was an example of throwing a pitch. Pitching is very simple because, what you do is... Hang on. I'm going to pause here. Pitching is very simple because you just need to aim at the crosshair, but you can turn that off to make things more interesting. Also, while we're here, pitching controls. You can see that square there. It's the strike zone. You can also see where balls have come in previously, so it might give you an idea of where the guy's going to throw them next. You can press the R button to go from contact mode to power mode. Contact mode doesn't hit as far as power mode, but power mode requires you to be a lot more precise. What else is there? I just want to be careful with how much I, So as you can see, I hit a strike there. Because I missed the ball. But there we go. I actually hit the ball, but it was a foul ball, so that doesn't really matter. Threw another ball. Please throw an actual, like, thing for me to hit this time. Nope, I missed, so I'm out. But I do get to bring out Jasmine this time, which is neat. There we go. That's an actual hit. So they're going to start running, but unfortunately I'm going to be caught out because it was a bad hit. That's unfortunate. Here comes Glasses Nerdy Man. Let that one go. So the idea of this is that you actually have to hit the ball pretty precisely as you play. And that's what the lock-on is useful for, because when you have the lock-on, No, run back. He made it. Alright. See, there's Fat Bastard. I really like this guy. I love his design. That's an awesome design to have. He's also a really good power hitter. So, can I actually get a good power hit off? Nope. Unfortunately, that guy's out, and that means we have to swap over. And the game will continue on for a little bit. Until we actually, we're pitching again. So, yeah, this is how the game goes. It is a basic game of baseball. So, I totally missed that. I fucked up. So, yeah, fielding controls are fairly simple. You press the circle button to go for, like, a grab or something like that. Oh, he's gonna try and bunt it. The fuck. Yeah, thankfully, I can just grab this and throw it and... Oh, it was a foul ball, was it? Okay, just a regular ball down the middle of... Nope, foul ball. So yeah, it is a basic game of baseball. Do you not know the rules of baseball at this point? You probably don't if you're watching this video fresh. So I'll explain the rules to you as much as possible. The idea is the pitcher has to throw the ball into the strike zone and try and get every individual batter to strike out, which is three strikes. If the person makes the swing, no matter if it's a ball or a strike, they will get the strike. Three outs and play switches over to the next team. If they hit the ball, they have to run to the base, and if they, if they run all the way around, they get a run, and obviously the team that has the most runs wins at the end of the 9 innings. If there's a tie, it goes on forever. Or for, like, as many innings as you have set in the options. The idea is that this game has a lot of potential strategies and a lot of potential ways to play. Nope, not gonna have that. Unfortunately, they're gonna get a run. They're gonna get two runs. Oh, this is not good. There's a lot of potential strategies and stuff to do with all of... With as simple as the rules are in this game, all these potential strategies are very simple. So, let's see if I can actually hit a ball this time and not actually get it knocked right out. Great. I could have power hit that just fine, and I just chose not to. That's a... Nope. Wait, nope, he's... Well, I got him under first base. That's a good start. There's a lot of strategies you can do. There's also individual controls for, like, running people around the field. Like, you have to... If you hit square... And, press a base that you want to be occupied, they'll start running to it, and you can order them all to stop and run back and stuff like that, and you can get them to run without the ball being hit and stuff like that. It just, there's everything you need for a arcade-style baseball game. I need to hit this next one if I can. Nope. I wasn't gonna try that. This guy's a dick with the curveballs. You even get these neat little replays. But yeah, as I said before, the game is actually surprisingly hard to control at first. Like, pitching is fine. Batting, pain in the ass. Like, seriously, a ridiculous pain sometimes. There we go. Wait, what? Oh, nope, he was out. Need to hit this next one. Still didn't hit it. There we go. Alright. Go, go, go. Okay, I got at least one run in. That's a decent start, at least. But once you get the controls down, and by getting the controls down, I mean, once you've spent, like, an hour or so in the training mode, like, probably more than that if you're not very good at games like this, once you spend an hour or so in the training mode, learning how and when to hit the ball, like, not like that, for example. Damn, I didn't get the run. He didn't get there in time. God damn it. Well, we're swapping out now, and the game will fast forward a bit. The unfortunate thing about this mode is that the AI can actually get an absolute ton of runs off screen, and that can kind of frustrate me. You can play the entire game through. Like, there might be an option that I completely missed that lets you play the entire game through. But that would take an absolute fucking age. Nope, not gonna risk running for the next base. I got to the base one. That's a good start. First base. Here comes Glasses Nerdy Man again. I love this guy. Probably could have hit that with a power hit. Alright, that was good. Because since they just both, like, completely missed that, now I've got two people on bases. And here comes Fat Bastard. Yes! And Fat Bastard hits a foul ball, unfortunately. Because playing a baseball game not only requires you to determine what balls that you can hit, but what balls that you don't want to even try and hit. So waiting for a good ball to hit is always a good strategy, and I did not follow my own rules there. Nope. God damn it. That was a ball. That was also a ball. It can actually be quite hard to tell what balls... Oh, shit. Damn it. Alright, gotta get this one. Gotta get this one. Gotta get this one. That was a bad ball from him. That's another bad ball. He's fucked up his pitching twice. I wonder if he'll do it again. Damn it! That's three outs. We have to swap sides now. Do I get to pitch again? Yep. No, I'm batting again this time. There we go. It did actually skip a little bit of my turn. So we have two outs and two bases. So I need to try and get this, but unfortunately, I'm not entirely sure if that's going to happen with Jasmine. Jasmine's all right as a pitcher, but as a batter. Nope. Had a feeling that wasn't going to happen. Yeah, it's really hard to hit things that are around the edge of the strike zone because you have to move your cursor to get there really quickly. And it's, as you can tell, it's quite sensitive. That's what I'm... Foul ball. Shit. That would have been a fantastic hit if it wasn't a foul. Can he make it? Can he make it? Can he make it? Nope. God damn it. Alright, Fat Bastard. It's all up to you, buddy. Just missed it. I do have lock-on mode turned on, but it doesn't seem to be helping me out much this time. If you have it up to 5, it moves, like, by itself, and it's weird. But yeah, it uses, like, the interior half of the analog stick to, shit. Is he gonna make it? He's gonna make it? Just missed. Fuck. Alright, two outs. Gonna need to try and get a run in. Nope. All he needed to do was run there. God damn it. But yeah, that's half time. Let's see. Okay, I'm batting again. We got one person on base. And that's gone way too high. Shit. So yeah, as you can see, it's really hard to get a good hit going. This is why I said practice is good, because I couldn't hit shit before this. Alright, let's see. One person on base. One person on base, no outs. Swung way too early for that one. Oh, he hit me. That's a free walk. Nope. It can't hold square to try and, well, not only introduce, like, the lock-on, but it also holds the cursor in place. So if you think you know where the ball's going, it's a good way to just... Shit. It's a good way to just, like, hold it at a particular spot. That's a foul. Let's try and just normal hit it. Nope, it was a fastball. Thankfully, I do get another shot at this. That looked like a bloody ball, but it was just inside the strike zone. And I missed that one. Come on. Shit! That was a good ball to hit, and I just missed it. Damn it. As you can see, really hard to get a good hit going. Alright, last chance. I have to get this done now. Alright, come here, you son of a bitch. Nope. Damn it! Damn it! That's a foul. I keep swinging too late, and then I start swinging too early. And this is going to turn out exactly the same way. Nope, she's actually safe. Here comes Glasses Boy. Nope, wasn't going to hit that. You can turn all of this off, by the way. It's kind of neat. That, nope, too high. He's got it. Shit. Don't believe it. I actually lost my first goddamn game. God, I suck. So, depending on the amount of points you get in-game and stuff like that, you get experience points, you get, you get points for all your teammates, and since I didn't win, I don't get to continue on, but I do get to carry my guy out into the rest of the game. Wait, what? God damn it, I thought... Maybe I have to get past the first game. I'll do it one more time, just for the purpose of demonstration, because you sat through 45 minutes of this video, and you didn't see any bloody baseball going on, so I'll skip through everything as fast as possible, and hopefully I'll be able to actually do better this time. It appears the lock-on actually stuffed me up somewhat. I mean, I had the lock-on item turned on, and it just didn't help. So, who knows? Maybe I'm doing better without the lock-on than with it. There is a digital mode that you can turn on that lets you move the, thing without it having, like, bounce back, or just having it be exactly where your, having it be exactly where your analog stick is. You can do that. That's entirely possible. I do actually have those, abilities translated. I just can't remember them off the top of my head. So, yep, Fat Bastard and, Jasmine again, because, yeah, why not? Better to focus on the people that you can get leveled up than just the ones that you can't. You can only take along one person at first, which is kind of annoying, because you get a bunch of good people at the very beginning. Alright, we'll just go straight into the verses, not waste any more time. Alright, who do I want to fight? Gives you a rough estimate of their, skill level, as you can see by the numbers there. Alright, we'll fight this weird-looking dude, because, I mean, chances are I'm going to fuck this up again anyway, because that's what I do in these sorts of videos. Oh yeah, I've got to hold square for this. Let's take this item, just so you can see what it does. I know what this does. It makes everyone's mood... At least I thought that's what it was supposed to do. Nope, I guess I had that wrong too. Alright, let's just go straight into the game, shall we? Bit more pitching, bit more batting, and... We can talk about how I feel about this game in general. Because holy hell, is it a game. Like, it's... It's weird. Like, it's really weird that I like a sports game this much. Like, I usually don't like sports games this much, but it's got that nice... I'm going to press triangle to skip the practice pitches. It's really weird for me to like a game as much as I do here, but the combination of arcade gameplay with simple to know, but easy to learn, hard to master, more or less, It's something else entirely, right? Like, it feels like an entirely different game to something like MLB The Show, where it's supposed to be entirely simulation, or at least that's what it feels like. Oh, bugger me sideways. Oh, he's back out, because of course he is. I'm going to try and throw it as far away as I can from him. If I get them out now, that won't be a... Shit. Looks like they're going to get some runs. Yeah, you better fucking stop there. And despite the fact that the game is actually surprisingly hard to get a hold of at first, I mean, sure, it's easy to learn how to play it, it's just hard to learn how to master it. Or, at the very least, learn how to hit properly. Don't catch it! Fuck! God damn it. You really do need to learn how to hit the ball properly, because there are places where they will always, like, catch it if you hit it. Which is why hitting it straight down the middle is actually, like, really good. Yes! It's alright. She's at least on base one. Good start. Classes, dude. Just the combination of it being easy to learn, hard to master, and all the different options that are there to, like, help you make the game easier or harder for yourself is... Fucking foul balls. It just makes the game really shit. It doesn't make the game really shit. It makes the game a lot like Dark Souls. Like, I know that's a bit weird to say, but it gives me that same feeling of, I want to keep playing it. It gives me that feeling of I want to keep playing it, which is, something you don't get very often, especially with sports games. Fuck! Come on, fat bast. Fuck! That's frustrating as all hell. Alright, I'm a bat again. Let's actually get this right this time. It also makes the game really frustrating, too. Like, can you tell? I've actually been really... Oh, great. It also makes the game really frustrating, because it is entirely too easy to fuck up a good potential for a hit. Oh, that sucks. And I got another run off screen, which is kind of frustrating, because that tends to happen a lot. The game has this tendency to skip the boring stuff, and apparently a run is boring. Yes, he's not gonna get it. He's not gonna get it. Just get the base one. Yes! At the same time, though, when you really get good, when you have a good team, when you have a... I swung for it, which means it still counts as a strike. That's... Oh, God, really? Shit! And apparently I didn't get to play the rest of that out, because fuck me, right? I'm sure there's an option there that'll let me change... Shit. I'm sure there's an option there that'll let me change that, but still. Foul ball. God damn it. Nope, not a foul ball. I'm really good at hitting foul balls. Like, seriously, a couple of hours of practice in the game's batting mode, and I'm still coming up with shit like this. Alright, rolls right past him, and that's more than enough time to get to the base. Right. Come on. Yes, rolls right past them, and I get to... I have first and second bases load. Good start. Nope, that's a foul ball. I was going to try and just, like, do a home run with this girl, because I believe I actually can do a home run with this girl, but, yeah. Alright, bases loaded, one out. Okay, basically, all I need to do is hit a good hit, and I've got a good chance of winning this one. That's a foul ball. That's a strike. Yes! Alright. It makes it entirely satisfying to play this game properly. It's very arcadey, yes, but... it is very satisfying to play this game properly. And when you do, you feel like the top of the fucking world, because... I mean, I'm not playing with the best in the way of batters or pitchers right now. Like, in my life mode, I'm playing with a guy who turned out really good. In this mode, I'm not playing with very good pitchers and stuff at all, so... yeah, getting this right... go. Go. Yes. Yes. 4-2. Yes. This actually does get harder. As I said, 18-17 in one of these matches. And it is entirely satisfying. And if you're willing to get over the language barrier... oh, that's not good. No, everybody stays where they are. If you're willing to get over the language barrier... it's definitely one of the better imports. Yes! He fumbled it! I get another shot! Awesome! Except I don't. Because it decided to skip nearly the entire rest of the game. But oh well, I mean, I'm winning by several points anyway. Fuck you! I get to do it to you for once! That's the end of the match! We win! We win! Oh, man. Nothing is more satisfying than pulling off an extremely good inning. I have to admit, all it takes is for a sports game to introduce me to a sport is be arcadey and be fun and be ridiculous. Virtua Tennis 4, somewhat ridiculous, but very arcadey. This game, extremely arcadey. Ridiculous theme. Just... overall, awesome. If you're willing to get over the language barrier, or if you're only willing to play something like My Life Mode, which doesn't require that much translation and interpretation, and I even get him. He comes along as part of my group now, and I can even bring along all his buddies if I want to. Well, I can bring along one of his buddies. I'll just bring along one of them. But yeah, I get to pick which one of his buddies I get to bring along, and I get to, I even get to bring some more, do I? All right, this guy. What does this guy do? He's a pitcher. No, he's a batter. He's very single focused. What about this one? Very good pitcher, actually. We'll bring him. So yeah, as you can see, this just gets replayable as more and more replayable as time goes on, because you get more characters, you get more character slots, you can figure out what all the items do, and it's a neat mode by itself just to play through, just to build up a good team and try to get to the end of the game and stuff like that. And again, there's tons of other different kinds of modes and stuff to do as well. So you can play through My Life Mode and bring your baseball all the way up. You can make a pennant and try and manage your team properly. You can do Success Mode if you feel like reading all that Japanese text. And even then, there's that silly Saku Success Mode, which lets you build a bunch of different characters and stuff like that. And as you can see, I've got a ton of experience points to work with here now. I'm actually going to save this game, because this game's going really well. And then you've got High School Management Mode, if you feel like being a little bit more tactical. And then you can just come and play, like, games of... should I actually play a Narikiri mode game? You know what? Fuck it, I will. Why not? This is Narikiri mode, I think. Oh, shit up my nose. I do not know. Let me just look up my notes here. I'm pretty sure I translated all this. Management. I did not translate any of this at all. Screw it. Back we go. I guess I won't bother, but it gives you like this little third-person camera that goes around your player, and it yeah, it gives you this little third-person camera around your player, and you can run around, and the controls are still the same, so it doesn't like it changes or anything. And it's just, it's a really cool game. Like, it's honestly one of the best imports I've gotten so far, and I'm kind of happy that I got it, because I was always debating getting this one, and then I got that partnership, and I'm just like, ah, maybe I can get this one now, and I did, and I love it. I get really frustrated at it, there's a lot to translate, but I really do enjoy the hell out of it. So, yeah. It's, I would fully recommend you pick this one up, if you're even remotely interested in it, because it is really, really good. Really customizable with your options to make it as easy as you need it to be. Tons of stuff to do in it. Your characters can carry over between all the individual modes. You can get tons of people's characters from offline and make your own custom league if you feel like it. It just, it does so much and it's just so good. So, yeah. It's been an hour and 20 minutes. I have to let you go before my throat gives out. So this has been Blue Maxima, and I'll see you all next time.